What if I told you that there was a special type of lens that, among many other cool uses, allows you to take a picture of a mirror straight on without getting any of the camera in the reflection at all? Yes, there is such a thing, and I'm gonna tell you about it, so prepare to have your mind blown. Before we jump in, it is essential that I do my shameless plugs, of course. If you haven't seen my incredible Instagram account, it has the most amazing tech memes you could possibly imagine, so be sure to check that out. It's just at TheoJoe over on Instagram if you wanna collapse from laughing so hard. And with all that out of the way though, let's get started. These days, considering everyone has a camera right in their pocket, when it comes to taking a picture, you've probably got it figured out. You just make sure the thing you want to photograph is in focus so it's not blurry, and then the things in front and behind it a certain distance will be out of focus. But there is one type of lens that most of you have probably never heard of that will completely change what you think you know. It's called a tilt shift lens. And even if you have heard of it, you might just know it as that weird effect that makes things look miniature, but the capabilities of these lenses are so much stranger than that. So let's get into what these lenses can do. The two unique abilities of these lenses are called tilting and shifting. Wow, big surprise. The first one we'll go over is shifting, which is actually really easy to understand and allows that weird ability to take pictures of mirrors I mentioned at the beginning. You see, how every lens works is the light comes in one end and out the other end, projecting what's called an image circle, and then you put the image sensor or film in that circle and it captures a portion of it to form an image. The bigger the sensor size, the bigger the image circle needed to cover it. A normal camera lens you buy is specifically designed to have an image circle just big enough to cover the sensor. But a tilt shift lens is different. It has an image circle much larger than a typical lens, and on the lens itself allows you to literally shift the lens side to side or up and down, therefore changing where the sensor is located in the image circle, therefore shifting the image. You might think, well, what's the point of that? Why not just move the camera itself left or right, or just put it up higher on the tripod? But it's not the same. A shift of just a few millimeters may be the equivalent of moving the lens anywhere from a few feet to 100 feet or more, depending on the focal length. This allows some abilities that would be impossible with a regular lens. For example, if you wanted to take a picture of a tall building, you'd probably have to point the camera upwards, which makes the building look warped, with the lines converging towards the top. With a tilt shift lens though, you can just point the camera level with the ground, then shift the lens up so the lines all stay parallel and vertical. To do that with a normal lens, you'd have to be high up in the air at the center of the building to get the same picture with the vertical lines. And now here's how to do the thing with the mirror. If you want to take a picture of a mirror with a regular camera without being in the reflection, you have to stand way off to the side and turn the camera at a strong angle, which is very obvious that you're not looking straight into it. With a tilt shift lens, you still need to place the camera just off to the side of the mirror, but you can point it perpendicular to the mirror, then shift the lens so the perspective looks like it's just pointed directly into it, but it's not. Shifting is also good, for example, for taking panoramas that you stitch together. You can simply shift the lens to the sides, taking multiple pictures, and then stitch them together so you don't have any weird distortion like you might get if you did the same thing by turning the camera. So that's the shifting, but what about tilting? Well, this is actually my favorite, and it's where things get really weird. As you probably know, when you focus a camera, there's a plane of focus that you can move forward and backwards, and that plane is always parallel to the sensor or the film. We call it the sensor plane. But when you tilt a lens and keep the sensor plane the same, something very strange happens. The focal plane actually rotates and tilts in the same direction as the lens. This allows you extreme control over what's in focus. So, say you have a row of objects you all want in focus. Instead of having to reduce the aperture to increase the depth of field, you can just rotate the depth of field so it's still shallow, but still gets everything in focus. For example, a lot of landscape photographers actually use tilt shift lenses, then tilt the focal plane forward so they can basically get the entire landscape perfectly in focus instead of having to just focus on infinity, sacrificing some of the focus closer in the scene. Another cool use is the miniature effect you've probably seen, and this is actually the result of aiming the whole camera downwards and then tilting the lens upwards, therefore tilting the focal plane backwards. This results in only a tiny amount of the scene intersecting with the focal plane, therefore creating a very shallow depth of field despite being not very zoomed in. So it tricks our brain into thinking we must be zooming in on something very small. Now, I still want to clarify some things because the way the focusing works is not as simple as tilting the lens, and the focal plane just tilts by the same amount. The actual way the focal plane relates to the tilt is called the Scheimpflug principle, but I'll try to simplify it as best I can without getting into the math of it. Basically, as you tilt the lens, imagine some lines extending from the sensor plane, the lens plane, and the focal plane. When there is no tilt, all of these are parallel and vertical. But as you tilt the lens forward by any amount, what happens is the focal plane also tilts by an angle, such that all three planes intersect at a single point no matter what. This means the actual tilt of the focal plane is determined by both the tilt angle of the lens and how far the lens is from the camera. An interesting consequence of this is that when the lens is tilted, if you try to focus, that also rotates the focal plane further. So you can get a ton of tilt from the focal plane with just a tiny bit of tilting the actual lens. So yes, even to the point of the plane literally being perpendicular to the sensor plane. Now, if all this sounds amazing, you might be surprised to find out that none of this is new. The exact math of the Scheimpflug principle was derived right around the early 1900s, but photographers knew about using tilting and shifting in lenses since the very beginning of photography itself. In fact, back in the days of cameras with bellows, they basically all were capable of moving the lens around to do the same movements as a tilt shift lens. So this is a rare instance where modern cameras actually lost a feature that used to be in all cameras. These old style cameras are still around though, and if you follow me on Instagram, you may have seen my large format camera I bought recently. And this is a field camera, so it's made to be slightly more portable than other big bellows cameras, but it still can do all the same movements as I described. So you can shift the lens in any direction and also tilt the lens side to side or forward and backwards. And what's nice about these old style cameras is you can do all of these movements no matter what lens you use, as long as it covers the film, obviously. And you can also tilt or shift the lens by any amount, even to an extreme degree, as long as the resulting image circle can still cover the film. So, fun fact, one spec you need to consider when buying an old lens like this is the size of the image circle it produces, which is never something you need to consider with modern lenses because they're standardized and don't need to do any tilting and shifting. Now, there are some things I should point out in regards to tilt shift lenses. When it comes to shifting, you might be wondering if instead of shifting using tilt shift, if you could just use a wider angle lens. And actually, yes, technically you could. If you were to look at the full image circle of a tilt shift lens, it would produce the same image as a wider angle lens. But the difference is, with the wider angle lens, you have to use the whole sensor on the whole image. So to get the same image as a tilt shift lens, you'd have to crop it down a lot, therefore losing a ton of quality. A tilt shift lens basically lets you take a really wide angle lens, but only capture whatever part of it you want at a higher quality because you're using the whole image sensor on just that part. Make sense? But remember, that just applies to the shifting. You can't replicate the tilt feature using any other lens. You need one that can physically tilt the lens. Now, by this point, you might be wondering how to get your hands on one of these lenses. And unfortunately, they're some of the more expensive lenses out there, because not only does the manufacturing have to provide additional controls for tilting and shifting for features, they also need extremely high quality optics to be able to project such a large image circle. An alternative to shifting could be to just get an extremely wide angle lens and cropping it down, but remember, that will reduce the resolution of the image substantially. As for tilting the lens, you might see lots of photo editing effects like on Instagram called tilt shift, which can do the effect where it blurs everything except a certain part of the image, but these obviously can't do the more useful ability of the tilt shift lens, which is to get more in focus. Now, one possible exception to all this would be tilt shift adapters, which would go between the camera sensor and the lens, then allowing you to add tilting and shifting. I know there are tilt shift adapters for really high-end cameras like Hasselblads, but I'm not sure if they really exist for typical full-frame cameras or even APS-C. So you might be able to do a lot of searching and find something like that, but I haven't seen too much about it. But anyway, that pretty much covers it. Let me know what you think down in the comments. The next video I'd recommend watching is one I made with 10 awesome computer accessories under $50. I'll put that link right here if you want to watch that. So thanks again for watching, guys. Be sure to subscribe and let me know what you think, and I'll see you in the next video.